President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni has held discussions with the International Olympic Committee IOC President Mr. Thomas Bach, whom he hosted at State House Entebbe. During yesterday's meeting, which was also attended by the First Lady and Minister of Education and Sports, Mrs. Janet Museveni informed Mr. Bach about Uganda's excellent record in athletics because of the favorable training factors.
You know, our people live on, here in Uganda where you are, is a high altitude country. Even here where we are sitting is 1,000 meters above the sea. So I think we should invite the athletes to come and train in our high altitude so that the lungs of those athletes learn how to economize oxygen.
He also expressed gratitude to the IOC for its initiative to involve the refugee community in sports through the Refugee Olympic Team. While highlighting the plight of refugees, the president also informed his guests that Uganda fully welcomes and supports refugees in the country. He, however, appealed to the international bodies that support refugees to offer more support to Uganda so that it can effectively fulfill the host requirements.
So when they run away, for us, we don't see any big problem other than the logistics and the feeding them and all that. This is what really, but when they come, we give them security. Then we also don't insist on putting them in refugee ghettos.
For the Ministry of Education and Sports, the First Lady, Mrs. Janet Museveni, expressed gratitude to host the IOC boss and his delegation. The First Lady reported that ever since Uganda became a member of the IOC in 1954, we have strived to uphold the values and principles of the Olympic movement, fostering sports as a tool for unity, development, and peace. Dr. Tanga Odoi, the chairperson of the NRM Electoral Commission, has guaranteed supporters in Chisoro District that the party is committed to ensuring peaceful primaries for the women MP by-elections. Speaking at the party offices in Chisoro Municipality on Thursday, Odoi emphasized that security teams have already identified potential hotspots and strategies are in place to address any disruptions.
We have met security. They have taken us through. We know the hostile areas. We know how to deal with them. But as a team, we are ready. We are ready to handle Kisoro District Woman MP election in a free and fair manner.
Ahead of the voting, a mini baraza will be held to finalize voter verification, concluding by 10:30 a.m., with voting commencing at 11 a.m. in all villages across Chisoro.
All candidates must, unless otherwise, have two agents in every polling station. And our polling stations are villages.
Yesterday, the NRM electoral staff from all sub-counties received training to enhance efficiency during the election process. Odoi cautioned candidates against inciting violence, stressing the importance of maintaining peace as they prepare for the upcoming general elections.
Today we are training our staff in all sub-counties. All sub-counties will be training staff who will handle election tomorrow.
Chigezi Regional Police Spokesperson Eli Mate confirmed that security personnel have been adequately deployed to ensure a smooth election process. This by-election follows the death of Sarah Mateke, the former State Minister for Defense and Veteran Affairs and Woman MP for Chisoro, in early September. The Democratic Republic of Congo's mineral-rich South Kivu province has suspended gold mining operations since July to cap hundreds of foreign companies, most of them Chinese-owned, from illegal extraction of valuable metal without permits and without declaring their profits. These companies mine at least 100 kilos of gold per month per company, says Governor of the province Jean-Jacques Purusi, who has stopped operations until companies can comply with Congolese mining laws. Under the legislation, companies would have to renew their mining permits, some of which have been expired for decades. Since the ban, farms which normally operate in the shadows have come in hordes to the governor's office in an attempt to get authorization to resume business.